With reference to the above passage, which of the following assumptions are valid? Now, wherever you are supposed to answer such questions, the idea is to go by the scope of the argument. The first option says the decentralization of power to the state governments was partly a result of the center's own policies. Is that applicable? The answer is no. The Congress-led government pursued a policy of discrimination against communist-ruled states. Is that exactly what happened? Or are we following victim to Chinese whispers? So the idea is, no, the Congress-led government did not pursue a policy of discrimination against specifically communist-ruled states. So the answer will be neither. Neither one nor two. Because clearly it's mentioned in the second paragraph, it was in 1967 that non-Congress parties or alliances first came to power in as many as 11 states. Subsequently, regional parties also came into power. Each of them had faced stepmotherly treatment by the Congress government at the center. So it's not only the communist government which had faced stepmotherly treatment by the Congress. It was all inclusive. So can we say specifically that the communist ruled states were victims? No, we can't. So the answer is D. Neither one nor two. Next question. One of the reasons for the long reign of the Communist Party could be inferred to be, you will have to elucidate that particular reason. Going by the scope of the argument, the importance that the left attached to supporting poor farmers and farmhands is the same. Clear? Because in the third paragraph, it's elucidated, though the land reform movement had been initiated by the Congress government as early as 1954 by abolishing the Zamindari system, it was not actively pursued and implemented by the successive Congress governments. On the other hand, the undivided Communist Party had, from the late 40s, been agitating to ensure a two-thirds share of crops for the sharecroppers, thus building a support base among the poor peasants in the state. It's explicitly stated. Now we go on to question number three. Answers to question numbers 1 and 2 clear? Please type yes. Okay. I got a yes. Now, question number 3. Consider the following statements. One of the restructuring projects that left government undertook was to give a stake to tenant farmers in the reforms process. Is that mentioned in the passage? Yes, it is. That is what is known as the Tebhaga. 2. The Congress government could have done away with certain archaic policies and created a level playing ground for the states. Could it have done so? It hasn't been explicitly mentioned. No, it has not been explicitly mentioned. Now we come down to third. The left was successful in judging the views of the masses. Yes, it was successful. It's mentioned clearly. After coming to power in 1977, the left aggressively pursued the program of giving rights to the sharecroppers by amending laws and distributing vested land to landless peasants. Fourth paragraph. In West Bengal, where the bulk of the peasantry is constituted by small and marginal farmers and the landless, this served a dual purpose. It made the sharecroppers and the landless peasants stakeholders in the left government's land reform initiative, and it was successfully hijacked the political agenda from the Congress. So the answer is C, 1 and 3 only. Clear? Now we come down to passage 2. This is about profit based institutions, and is the government getting into education sector along with that kind of agenda? Which of the following questions does the passage attempt to answer best? If you have any doubts, please ask. Which of the following questions does the passage attempt to answer best? The answer will be, please type in your answer. Yes. I got an answer from Pragati Jaju. Yes. A is the right answer. Should for-profit companies be allowed to run schools? That is exactly the scope of the argument. Question number 5. All the following arguments have been placed in favor of privatization of schools except. Now, out of the given 4 options, 3 have been placed in favor of privatization. Except 1. And the answer is, type in your answer. Yes, Rajakrishna Singh has marked the right answer, it's C. It will help bring in an uncomplicated and transparent regulatory mechanism. What regulatory mechanism are we talking about? It has not been explicitly mentioned. So therefore, C is the right answer. Question number 6. According to the passage, it can be inferred. The best system in school education would be. The answer is B. Kushant Pandav answers correctly. Right? Krishna Singh has marked A. A mixed system in which the corporate would not be allowed to invest in the for-profit schooling system. That is not the right answer. Because the logic of the argument is a mixed system in which both the government and the private schools are allowed to function. Not a mixed system in which the corporate world would not be allowed to invest in the for-profit schooling system. What are the two entities which are participating entities? They are government and the private schools. Not the corporate world per se. So D falls out of the scope of the argument. Clear? Please ask a question. Madan Krishna saying, is it clear? Good, okay. Now we come down to passage 3. This is about groundwater maximization. Why does the author present a case for the expansion of groundwater irrigation? The answer is, Radhakrishna Singh and Sonu Tomar both have answered it correctly. Yields in groundwater irrigated areas are higher by 33 to 50% in comparison to areas irrigated by surface resources. Abhijit Singh says, question number 5, not clear, factually based, he says, why not D, okay. It's a substitute for the inabilities and failures of the government? Yes, 5th question, option D says, it's a substitute for the inabilities and failures of the government? Are the inabilities and failures of the government only related to placing in favor of privatization? ये तो सही है, फोर सही है। नाउ वी गो ऑन टू फिफ्थ। सर फिफ्थ anywhere, so why will D be there? Which question number 5 are you talking about? Because 5th has been repeated in the PPT. Okay, there is a discrepancy in what I have in front of me and the PPT which is running. So, I understand it, Abhijit. I understand it completely. Your query is rightly considered. Yes, D should be the exception then, but you are not talking of the same answer where I am there. Yes, I'm with us. I can't see it. Clearly, I can't see. Yes, fifth answer is C. D. Abhijit, in the paper it is C. Beta, just have a look. Question number 5 has the answer C. Now we come down to the passage on groundwater. Why does the author does the case for the expansion of groundwater irrigation? Abhijit, we will discuss it at the end. 7. Why does the author present a case for the expansion of groundwater irrigation? The answer is C. Yields in groundwater irrigated areas are high by 33% to 50% in comparison to areas irrigated by surface resources. There. Question number 8. Consider the following statements. The answer will be C, because both of them are valid. An important factor that leads to the increase in agricultural yields is the ability to control the supply of groundwater to crops. And secondly, the vulnerability of farmers to natural hazards can be reduced by their access to natural resources like groundwater. So then, if a famine strikes, then the surface water dries up, and then it is the groundwater which is taken into consideration. It's clearly mentioned in the second last paragraph, groundwater irrigation reduces the risk that investment in labor, seed, fertilizers, pesticides, and other inputs should be lost in drought or the variability of precipitation phenomena, while higher yields enable households to generate surpluses. Question number 9. Each of the following options has been mentioned. Having a deep-rooted distrust for the corporation does not mean... Radhakrishna saying, this is to your query, that having a deep-rooted distrust for the corporation does not imply... the same as given in option D. A mixed system in which the corporate would not be allowed to invest in the for-profit schooling system. It is not allowed to invest in the for-profit system. Investment is something different. Always go by the scope of the argument. You are supposed to answer exactly what is being asked. Right? Not something which is Anant Akash says, because statement 3 of the question is not explicitly mentioned. Anant, we have come down to question number 7 now. If you are having any doubts, please type in the question number immediately. Always, are the assumptions being inferred according to the view of the author? Question number 7. No, it's explicitly mentioned here. Abhijit Singh. In India, for example, research indicates that yields in groundwater irrigated areas are higher by 1/3 to 1/2. Than in areas irrigated from surface resources, under 70 to 80% of India's agricultural output may be groundwater dependent. The second, yes, question number 7, C should be the answer. B cannot be the answer because B says it affects both the environment and the day-to-day life of most people living in rural and urban areas. B is a very generic option. It affects both the environment. How are we even considering the environment? We are only bothered about the agricultural output. And the day-to-day life of most people living in rural and urban areas. Again, the sample set is going to the urban areas. We are not considering people living in urban areas. Abhijit, is that clear? Okay. Now, Shweta Desai asks question number 8. Shweta Desai, question 8. Consider the following statements. Both of them have been taken into consideration and both of them are valid. Both 1 and 2. C is the right answer. Radhakrishna saying has marked the right answer. 8th answer. Yes, the assumptions being inferred are according to the view of the author. Yes. They are very subjective. 9. Each of the following options has been mentioned as a benefit of having access to groundwater except for better investment opportunities. Rest all are present. A, C, and D are present. Yes, 9 answer is B. Vijay Kumar is right. 10th, on Saturday, CBI carried out raids at 5 places here after registering a case against ex Army Chief D.K. Singh on Lieutenant General Tejinder Singh, complained that he was offered right to clear a deal of 600 trucks. Based on the above information, 4 conclusions as given below have been made. Which one of these logically follows from the information given above? The scope of the argument with umbrella logic into consideration is B, B for Bombay. 10, answer is B, B for Bombay. That CBI conducted raids to confirm whether D.K. Singh offered a bribe or not. 11. Use of Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism will increase leakages and increase the efficiency and accountability of the government social sector scheme. Will be used for making pension payments, among other things. Umbrella logic. Okay, Abhijit Singh asks about umbrella logic. Abhijit, umbrella logic is that logic in which we consider an umbrella wherein an umbrella statement in which the maximum number of factors as given in the option is taken from the scope of the argument. Whichever factor is going out of the scope of the argument, we tend to calculate those factors. Like, if in a certain scope of the argument, some certain factors have been enumerated, and if another, and if in any other option, a few as compared to the previous one have been enumerated, we will take the first one as the right answer. In 10, D.K. Singh asked CBI to investigate Tejinder Singh's case. No. It has never been explicitly stated. CBI is suspicious of both D.K. Singh and Tejinder Singh. Not necessarily. CBI conducted raids to confirm whether D.K. Singh offered a bribe or not. That is the point in question. So this is included in that umbrella. Clear? Okay. Now, use of Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism, question number 11, answer is B. Which question are you referring to? 9. Because it is clearly mentioned, reduced risk in investment has been explicit. Sorry, 11. Will not have any benefits. Does it follow that? Koi bhi benefit nahi hoga. No, there will be benefits. But pension schemes might not benefit from an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism. Are you getting the point? Benefit to hoga, but pension-based schemes might not benefit from an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism. Why not see it relevant? Ask Abhijit Singh. Government social sector schemes do not need an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism. Does the government social sector schemes, refer to the sample, go by the scope of the argument, does the government social sector schemes do not need an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism? Has it been explicitly mentioned anywhere? If yes, then kindly mark and state it. It has not been mentioned. It cannot follow logically. efficiency kam hona aur uska use khatam ho jana are two different things, remember. Okay, now we come down to question number 12. A system can always be improved, but not every system needs to be improved. You will have to consider the scope of the argument, behas ka mudda. The behas ka mudda says, based on the information above, four conclusions is given below have been made, which one of these logically follows. There is a limit to the extent to which a system can be changed. Ye behas ka mudda nahi hai. A is not the right answer. B, improvement is sometimes not needed, is exactly the correct answer. 12B, right answer. Radha Krishna saying you are right. 13th question. Success happens in the world while determination comes from within. Which is the logical conclusion? Type in your answers. Hold on. A few students have problems. Rahul Bharadwaj. Hello. Yes. Radha Krishna Singh asks, my 11th question is not clear. 11th question is, beta, Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism will increase leakages and decrease the efficiency and accountability of the government social sector schemes. It will be used for making pension payments among other things. Yeh author ka inference hai. Yeh author ka personal opinion hai. Based on the above information, four conclusions as given below have been made. Which one of these logically follows from the information given above? Now, what is the logical conclusion? Kya yeh keh raha hai ki the government social sector schemes do not need an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism? Aapko yeh kaise pata chal gaya? The use of Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism will increase leakages and decrease the efficiency and accountability of the government's social sector scheme. Agar ye mentioned hai, so if they have some flaws, why will it not increase the need? Why will it not need the Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism? See, the logic logic is, the logic is, if you need something, or us jo requirement cheez hai, jo bhi requirement policy hai, policy jo bhi required hai, usme agar kuch khamiyan hai, usme agar kuch shortcomings hai, lacune hai, right? So, if you need something, you'll always need that thing. The argument does not logically follow because it is null key encrypted. The idea is an explicit statement has been made. It will be used for making pension payments among other things. So, क्या हम लोग ये कह सकते हैं कि pension schemes might not benefit from an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism? Yes, because it will be used for pension payments, and because it has got increased leakages and decreased efficiency in accountability to the government social sector schemes, and pension is a social sector scheme, hence pension schemes might not benefit from an Aadhaar-based delivery mechanism. It is falling into the cross section of the Venn diagrams, where the Venn diagrams are overlapping each other. The intersection. Question number 12. वो ये कह रहा है कि a system can always be improved, but not every system needs to be improved. पहले A देख लेते हैं. There is a limit to the extent to which a system can be changed. क्या सिस्टम के चेंज करने की लिमिट्स की बात की गई है आर्ग्यूमेंट में, प्रेमिस में? कहीं नहीं की गई. सो वी विल नॉट कंसिडर दिस. सी, एवरी सिस्टम विल हैव इनहेरेंट लिमिटेशंस. फिर से लिमिट्स की बात हो रही है, लिमिट की कहीं बात नहीं करी गई. सी इज आउट ऑफ द स्कोप. डी, इट इज ह्यूमन नेचर टू ट्राई एंड इम्प्रूव थिंग्स. ह्यूमन नेचर कहाँ जिक्र किया गया है? देयर इज नो मेंशन ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर. सो Human nature per se is bringing the option D out of the scope of the argument. Behas ke mudde mein hai improvement and sometimes which is not needed. So that is an explicit statement which is derived as an explicit deduction from the premise. A system can always be improved, but not every system needs to be improved. Kyunki system, har system ko improvement ki zarurat nahi hoti hai. So improvement is sometimes not needed. Question number 13. Answer given by Anand Takash is correct. योगेश मदान
सर, जो अनम्यूट है ना,
योगेश मदान बी, बट वाई नॉट ए? आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट 13 योगेश? Determination leads to success. ये if and only if necessary sufficiency condition है. क्या determination success के पहले आता है? Determination जरूरी है success के लिए? हाँ, with normal logic yes, but with the logic in the premise क्या कह रहा है? ये देखिए, success happens in the world while determination comes from within. Success दुनिया में होता है, लेकिन determination अंदर से आता है. So determination has got no causative relationship to success. डिटर्मिनेशन की वजह से सक्सेस होता है ये कहीं एक्सप्लिसिटली मेंशन नहीं, इसलिए ए नहीं होगा। क्लियर मनीष? योगेश? ओके हाँ, ये जरूर कह सकते हैं कि सक्सेस एंड डिटर्मिनेशन आर नॉट द सेम, एक दुनिया में होता है दूसरा अंदर से आता है, यहीं तक हम लोग बात को तय कर सकते हैं। देयर इज नो सक्सेस विदाउट डिटर्मिनेशन। तो इससे सक्सेस और डिटर्मिनेशन का रिलेशनशिप एस्टैब्लिश करने की कोशिश करी गई है, विच इज नॉट राइट। Question number 14. Answer is Sagar Chaurasia says D, D is the right answer. That means this Kumar says D, D is the right answer. Any doubts? Please ask. Anand Akash also says question number 14, D, D is the right answer. Radha Krishna Singh says C, Manish Malhotra is rightly saying D. Radha Krishna saying, why will C be the answer? Let me write it for you. Capital G. Capital G is gold and small g is glitter. G gives rise to anything with a bar on it is exactly the opposite of it. There is no glitter if there is gold. So if there is gold, there is no glitter. Capital G being gold, there is no glitter. Glitter gives rise to not rich people. No glitter gives rise to not rich people, and no rich people give rise to people buying cars, car buying. So if there is gold, people are not rich. Clear? Just hold on. If you have gold, right, there is no glitter, right? Is it okay? Then the second statement says only people are rich only if there is glitter, the third statement. So if there is glitter, only in that case people are rich. This is a necessary and a sufficient condition because it's only if. Rich honge, jab glitter hoga jab rich honge. So glitter hai to rich hai. Rich people, RP. Ab glitter nahi hai to rich पीपल भी नहीं है, विच इज द सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट. दिस वन, द वन इन द ब्लॉक. नाउ द थर्ड स्टेटमेंट विच इज द मैथमेटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट गिवन हियर, ओनली रिच पीपल बाय कार्स. अगर वो रिच नहीं है, अगर रिच पीपल बार है, वो रिच पीपल नहीं है, तो वो कार बाइंग सीबी नहीं कर पाएगा. सो विद दैट लॉजिक वी गो ऑन टू डी. इफ देयर इज गोल्ड पीपल आर नॉट रिच, इफ देयर इज गोल्ड देयर इज नो ग्लिटर, राइट? इफ देयर इज नो ग्लिटर देन पीपल आर नॉट रिच, एंड इफ पीपल आर नॉट रिच देन दे कैन नॉट बाय कार्स. क्लियर? There are no shortcuts to solving such questions. This is the easiest way. Question number 15. Answer is, Anand Akash gives me the right answer. Question number 15, answer is D. Shweta Daisy says A. A is not the right answer for D, for 15. Are the requirements for effective learning in place in the rural Indian setting today? The answer is an unequivocal no. Looking at any metric of educational effectiveness, the picture suggests that these requirements are not in place and the quality of government schooling is low. Which of the following identifies an assumption in the argument made above? Is pure thematic appreciation ke liye kya assume kiya gaya hoga? That all metrics of educational effectiveness can be trusted to a certain extent. Without this assumption, as given in D, hum log is natije mein nahi pahunch sakte the. If you answer A, all metrics of educational effectiveness are equally correct, then if that would have been the assumption, then we would not have been able to come up to this conclusion. Anand, the difficulty level of question number 15 is easy. Preeti Sharma asks, why not C for 15? Effective learning in the rural Indian setting is a key concern for the government. Rural Indian setting mentioned here in the premise. But the premise argument is, looking at any metric of educational effectiveness, the picture suggests that these requirements are not in place and the quality of government schooling is low. So has it been dead in C? मैं कह रहा हूं की कंसर्न फॉर द गवर्नमेंट. मनीष, एजम्पशन टाइप क्वेश्चंस को सॉल्व करने का तरीका एक ही है. यू विल हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रेमिस, मेक अ लॉजिकल कनेक्ट बिटवीन द टू statements given in the premise and whether the third statement coming out of that juxtaposition of premise 1 over premise 2 will be within the scope of the argument presented as in premise 1 and premise 2. But it's not. Yes, Raja Mishra, you are right. I have read your... You can reverse it and find out. Question 16. Answer is... Type in your answers. That means the answer for question number 16 is not D. Preeti, the answer for question number 15 is not B. 16 ka answer hai B. Right. Pragna Paramita Mohanti, the answer is not C. C is favoring the argument. Almost everyone who visits Great Lakes in winter visits Great Lakes again in the summer the same year. Great Lakes is surely the best tourist destination you can think of. Natural conclusion. Jo bhi winter mein jata, wo bhi summer mein bhi jata. He says some people who visit Great Lakes moves to another places for after a few days. So agar usse pasand aa raha hai Great Lakes, why will he move away for after a few days? Yogesh and Pragna Paramita Mohanty, your answers are wrong. It's not B, it's C. Why not me? Asks Manish Malhotra. I'm explaining, Prachyaparamita. There is a sound if a tree falls. So tree falling gives rise to sound. Forests give rise to trees. Third option says a tree falls only if there is a sound. So it is only if. Sound only say tree falls. Falling will give rise to sound. Forests will give rise to trees. And sound will give rise to trees. Falling. And if this sound giving rise to tree falling is an only if statement as given in 3, then tree falling is also giving rise to sound. So if there is no sound, only if a tree does not fall, will be the right answer as given in C. Only if a tree falls, there is sound. Sound ka hona aap proof nahi kar sakte. साउंड का ना होना आप प्रूफ कर सकते हैं, और साउंड का ना होना अगर प्रूफ कर पा रहे हैं जैसा कि सी में है, सो दैट इज द डेफिनेट कंक्लूजन, दैट इज द आईडिया ऑफ नल की एन्क्रिप्शन. कोई चीज का ना होना वी कैन प्रूव, वो डाउट को हटा देता है. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ देयर आर 5 बॉयज इन द क्लास, देन इफ अ टीचर आस्क्स आउटसाइड द क्लास हाउ मेनी girls are there, then is that question valid? Yes, that question is valid. If I say that there are no students in the class, and then if the teacher asks how many girls are there in the class, then is that question valid? That question then becomes invalid. Because I have mentioned that there are no students in the class. That is the idea of null key encryption. One को प्रेजेंस, किसी भी चीज के प्रेजेंस से लॉजिक गेट में उसका फर्दर आउटकम क्वेश्चन हो सकता है, लेकिन किसी चीज के एब्सेंस से लॉजिक गेट में उसका फर्दर कंक्लूजन क्वेश्चन नहीं किया जा सकता. तो अगर कोई चीज नहीं है तो दैट इज मच मोर डेफिनेटिव, दैट इज द ओनली डेफिनेटिव. सो देयर इज नो साउंड, ओनली इफ अ ट्री डज नॉट फॉल इज अ डेफिनेट कंक्लूजन. साउंड बी में किसी और चीज की वजह से भी हो सकता है. कह रहा है देयर इज अ साउंड इफ अ ट्री फॉल्स, लेकिन ये कहीं नहीं कह रहा कि ओनली इफ अ ट्री फॉल्स देयर इज अ साउंड. साउंड तो शेर की वजह से भी हो सकता है. राहुल भारद्वाज, इन द सेकंड स्टेटमेंट इफ और ओनली इफ विल डेफिनेटली मेक अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस. If is a sufficient condition and only if is a necessary condition, and if and only if is a necessary and a sufficient condition. यहाँ पे if and only if दोनों ही prove हो रहे हैं first और third statement की वजह से. So C, which negates the event from happening, will also negate the outcome of the event from happening. And hence it will be the right answer. Here, question number 18. Answer. He out of the scope hai. The judicial system cannot be biased on principle. Manish, the answer to question number 19 is D. Life exists when water is present. वाटर के होने पे लाइफ होगा, स्काई के क्लियर होने पे प्लैनेट प्रेजेंटिंग, प्लैनेट वाटर के होने पे स्काई क्लियर होगा, डेफिनेट कंक्लूजन. प्लैनेट्स आर नॉट सीन इन द स्काईज unclear. Why? Because in the second statement, planets are seen only if the sky is clear. This one statement may. This is a only if statement. Only if statement may. Sky clear hoga, to planets dikhenge. Planets dikhenge, to sky clear hoga. If life exists, the sky is clear. As said by Manish Malhotra, is wrong. Life ke saath sky ka relation kis statement mein establish ho raha hai? Kisi statement mein nahi hai. 19D is right. यहाँ पे राधा कृष्ण सिंह the assumption is given as a premise. These are syllogisms. Logical consistency syllogisms. Which is logically consistent. After logically consistent चीज को आप cause effect relationship में study करें. You cannot go back to the assumption. Assumption तो premise का हिस्सा है. Question number 20. Answer. That means your answer is right. It's none of the above. you bad or hungry? All poor are different types, and no hungry is poor. Poor? All poor are different types. Infantile are men. Some infantile are men. Shaded region. From the above four statements, it may be concluded that some men are poor? No. Some infantile are hungry? No. No hungry is infantile? Not necessarily. Because then in that case, the set of infantile may even extend to hungry. You have to consider that option, which is proving, which is disproving the entire premise, right? You see the line, the dotted line? That might be the case. Manish, that's a possibility. आपको वो ढूंढ निकालना है कि किसी भी तरीके से ये सिलोजिज्म गलत हो जाए. आपको A, B, C या D में से चारों के चारों को गलत प्रूफ करने की कोशिश करनी पड़ेगी. जिसको आप गलत किसी भी फॉर्मेट में प्रूफ नहीं कर पाएंगे, वो आपका राइट आंसर होगा. In conditions of may or may not be, you will have to take into consideration ki wo may ho sakta hai. Ikkisma sabar. No cardinal is a pope. Some pope are clergy. All clergy are Byzantine. Some Byzantine are cardinal. There is some common part. It may be concluded that some Byzantines are poor. Hey. Yeah? Okay. 20 seconds. See, is the right answer. Radha Krishna, Dharmendra, both of you have marked the right answer. Shweta has also marked the right answer. Yes, 20 second answer is right. See, Manish, you have got the right answer. 23rd. Radha Krishna, your answer to the 23rd question is right. It's B. Manish asked me about question number 21. What is your doubt? मुर्गी काटना बन रहा है, बन सकता है, लेकिन एब्सेंस ऑफ द कंडीशन गिव्स मी द श्योरिटी दैट दिस इज नॉट द आंसर, दैट इज नॉट द एनक्रिप्शन. कोई चीज नहीं होना साबित कर देता है कि वो ऑप्शन गलत है. मुद्दा ये है कि यू विल हैव टू फाइंड आउट द रॉन्ग आंसर. ऐसे बहुत सारे केसेस हो सकते हैं, राइट? 23 बी साबित हो रही है, यू हैव गॉट इट राइट. 24 क्वेश्चन आंसर. D is the right answer, Manish. D cannot be the answer. Is it clear with the Venn diagram, the second Venn diagram? There may be a chance that D and J have some part is common, right? Am I clear? Question number 24. D becomes wrong here. Manish, he's saying all ORM, right? All ORM in this case as well as in this case, okay? Some J are M, some J are M. So this may be a case, and this may be a case also. There is nothing mentioned about O and J. Okay? So how can you say no J is O? Okay? Do we still have any doubt in the surrounding questions? Radha Krishna, assumption questions when we arrive at, so we'll definitely solve it, right? Okay? Any doubt left in the surrounding part? Okay. We come down to passage 1 on page 12. We'll do the quant questions and DI questions later. First, the English part. Answer to question number 29. Preeti, you've got the right answer. It's only 2. B. Shweta, both 1 and 2 nahi hoga because internationally women workers nahi kaha gaya hai, domestic workers kaha gaya hai. Sagar Charasia, answer to question 29, B is right. Question 30, answer. Any doubts? Any doubts? answer to question number 30 is? Sagar, it's not B, it's D. If set, they would hamper the implementation of the new provisions . Will this explain why the provision of minimum wages is missing in the convention? Significantly, but not surprisingly, stipulations on minimum wages are missing in the convention. Notwithstanding this omission, the objectives entailed in the new standard could potentially alter the situation on the ground quite radically. Notwithstanding. It can be inferred that in India, the benefit of regulating domestic work would also be? 31 ka answer, Sagar Charasia, you have got it right, it's B. Any doubts? Question number 32. Answer is B. B for Bombay. The previous visa rules were more restrictive than the ones in the new agreement. Only this is the generalistic argument. Rest are wrong. Any doubts? Ask. Question number 33. What does the author mean when he states the foreign ministers emphasizing need to learn from history without being held hostage to it? Answer is C. Good question, Abhijit Singh. In 33, it's C instead of D, because in D, the two countries can learn from past mistakes. Can learn nahi hoga, have to learn. And plus, the second aspect is not dwelling on the negatives for too long. Ye behas ka mudda nahi hai, that is not the scope of the argument. Scope of the argument is handle the present with a mature outlook. Main agar ye kahu ki Rahul is a good boy, that does not mean Rahul is not a bad boy. He can be a bad boy as well. Provided good and bad at two states of a person's being. Or more evidently, if I say Rahul is not a bad boy, that will not mean that Rahul is a good boy. Two are different things. So in a scope of the argument, you'll have to look at exactly what is being said. Indeed, the two countries can learn from past mistakes and must not dwell on the negatives for too long. This is a personal opinion of the author. The two countries have to learn from the past and handle the present. the last paragraph, Rahul Bharadwaj, in the last paragraph, it's mentioned. 34 question answer from Shweta Devi is right. Author's attitude towards new visa agreement is hopeful. It's correct. Passage 3. Question number 35 answer is, please type in your answers. Manish, the question from 35 is not A. The diverse perspectives of the Indian education system are a result of the varied education needs in the country. No. In fact, both A and B are not right. It is difficult to bring in reforms because of the opposition experienced from the political class. Nowhere has it been mentioned explicitly. You can't even infer it. Answer is D. Neither one nor two. Question number 36. Manish, your answer to question number 36 is absolutely correct. It's D. Which one of the following statements cannot be inferred from the passage? That introducing a new organization that will oversee policy issues and implementation with reference to the education sector has not been mentioned in the passage. Clear? Good. Question number 37. According to the author, which of the following is essential for public-private partnerships to work? Answer. Manish, this time also your answer is absolutely correct. It's B. Ensuring a wide range of experience in non-profit oriented partners across the country. Anybody else has marked any other option? Question number 38. 38 question. Manish, your answer is again right. It's D. Neither the RTE, that is the Right to Employment Act, can be implemented without much difficulty. That's untrue. The education system is decadent and can never change in our lifetime. That is nowhere mentioned. It can definitely be changed. And that is what is exactly the author hinting at. 39. Question 39. Which of the following statements follows from the passage? Answer is A. There is usually consensus on whether we need to reform the education sector or not. The answer cannot be 2. The RTE Act neglects the importance of the teacher education system, of course not. The right answer is A, 1 only. Not D, neither 1 nor 2, no, not D. A is definitely the right answer. Then we cross over and come down to question number 50. Passage. The last four passages. We live in a legal environment. It's a It is clearly stated in this passage. Yet, ask someone with some knowledge of India's education system if there is a critical issue that needs to be set right, and you will get a ready list. There will be consensus, possibly even unanimity, cutting across ideological boundaries. Go to the first line of the second paragraph in passage 3 on page 14. Manish, you'll have to go to the passage's second paragraph. It's clearly elucidated there, clearly mentioned. Okay, Manish, good. Good that you got it. Okay, now we go on to question number 50. We live in a legal environment passage. First question, consider the following assumption. What is your answer? Please come up with your answers. Preeti, Manish, Shweta. Cannot be both 1 and 2, Manish. The momentary ban on publication of court proceedings has affected the freedom of expression? No. Shweta says it's B2 only. 2 has not been mentioned. It's A1 only. Gag orders on the press were justified in the past due to the possibility of jurors being influenced by the news. Question number 51. It can be inferred that the Mirajkar case is significant because yes, Rahul, Preeti, both of you are right. 51, answer is B. Shweta, juror is a person who sits in the jury. He or she is a jury member. He or she looks at the court proceedings and gives his or her entire jurisdiction to the judge, who, after listening to the jurors, reads out the statement. Preeti, you are right. 52nd is C. Absolutely right. Manish, the answer to 52nd question will be C. Without public scrutiny, the legal system may grow lax due to the lack of accountability. B, kahi mentioned nahi hai, ban on publicizing court cases will lead to a weakening link between the judiciary and the common man. That is exactly what they are talking about. Abhijit, because that is exactly what they are not talking about. It clearly states, in such a context, the Supreme course that would justify in temporary manner the publication of court proceedings in such cases is likely to have a chilling effect on the freedom of the press and the very idea of an open trial. Mercifully, the court refused to lay down broad guidelines for reporting ongoing cases. But though its order looks like a restatement of the Nirankar case in which a 9-member bench ruled that the right to open justice is not absolute, the court has likely upset the difficult constitutional balance between freedom of expression and the administration of justice. That's the landmark 1966 judgment established. Very first paragraph, middle. Now we come down to question number 64. Is B is correct. Shweta, the answer to question number 53 is A. The author asks us to set aside the judicial reasoning and consider its possible impact in order to A. Direct attention to the possible real-life impact of the Supreme Court's judgment. Point out that the judicial reasoning is fallible in certain situations? No. That is not the true answer for why the author is asking us to set aside the judicial reasoning and consider its possible impact. So the answer will be one only, which is A. Santosh Meena, your answer to question number 50 is A is correct. Now we come down to question number 64. Why was H father proud of him? Please type in your answers. Preetish Sabhavan, you've got it right. B. Sweta Devi, you've got it right. Rangam Paramita Mohan, you've got it right. Preetish Sharma, you've got it right. Sonali Patil, your answer is also right. Manish, your answer is also right. It's B, it's unanimous. Two only. 65. Examine the following statements. A used to read only during the evening. Fire was a luxury for all the settlers. Did A read during only the evening? No. Was fire a luxury for all the settlers? No, because wood was plentiful and we needed to keep the fire high and make a splendid blaze. So, for question number 65, neither 1 nor 2, D will be the answer, D for Delhi. Santosh, your answer is right. Preeti, your answer is right. Vijay Kumar, your answer is right. Manish, your answer is right. For 65. 66. Abe used to. Preeti, your answer is right. Both work with the father in the field sometimes. Write his own name in the snow, on wood, and in the earth. So both 1 and 2. Manish, your answer is also right. C is the right answer. Santosh, your answer is correct. 66, answer is C. Now we come down to the Stephen Baker section. Question number 67. The answer is, Preeti, your answer is right. Stephen Pinker is a psychologist. Monish Bhavale, your answer is correct. 67. C is the right answer. Question number 68. Any problems with 67? 68. The answer is B. Preeti Sabharwan, you are right. Manish, 68, answer is C is wrong because 1 will not be right. Long-term memories cannot be correct. Why not C? Because he clearly mentions it here. later claimed that he decided on the spot to become paleontologist years before he even learned the word. However, Harvard psychologist Steven Pinker does not believe this oft-told story. He does not believe it. Why doesn't he believe it? Because Pinker relays that Gold dedicated his first book to see the Tyrannosaurus when I was 5 years old. He was coming up with that charming line. He doesn't believe it. That is why 68 answer has to be B. Because he is going against the logic of long-term memories connecting to what you will be doing later on in life. Pinker says that long-term memory is notoriously untrustworthy. It clearly states it. So, long-term memory cannot be correct. Is not the right answer. Not correct is false, whereas untrustworthy is you cannot trust on it. Your answer is also correct. Manish Sharma, your answer is also correct. Rahul, your answer to 69B is wrong. Only those who become scientists remember the childhood experience of books and museums where it's been written. Santosh, 69B is not the right answer. Only those who become scientists remembering their childhood experience of books and museums, then why would Stephen Jay Gould be able to remember it? That's exactly why he's saying so. We come down to question number 70 now. The answer is D is correct. Mr. Mohanty, 70B will not be correct. Did not have a privileged upbringing? No, that's incorrect. It's clearly written in the third line that Orwell would begin to assert his independence from his privileged upbringing. So he had a privileged upbringing, not an unprivileged upbringing. Mr. Mohanty, Santosh, your answer is correct. 71. Answers. Please type in your answers. Rahul, your answer, 71B is correct. What will not be the right option because Orwell was always against conventional wisdom? No, he was not always against conventional wisdom. He was unhappy at accepting the conventional social wisdom. But conventional wisdom ke wo khilaf nahi tha. Yes, prior to that, if you read, he was unhappy at accepting the conventional social wisdom. He was not against conventional wisdom. Conventional political wisdom ke khilaf nahi tha. Conventional financial wisdom ke khilaf nahi tha. Social wisdom ke khilaf tha. So, you cannot take one aspect of a certain entity to be the Bozo criteria for measuring the effectiveness of the entire entity. You have to take the holistic and all and each and every component of all the entities, and only then can you reach to a certain judgment. Because what does not work? So C to ho hi nahi sakta. Was definitely unhappy about his upbringing. When you are growing up in a middle class and you are wanting to spend time as a tramp, an inference-based question, Abhijit. Here in the second paragraph, it's clearly stated he wanted to experience life from the view of the gutter. So when you are being born in a middle class and you are wanting to spend time as a tramp, wanting to experience life from the gutter, then definitely he was unhappy about his upbringing. He did not want to live with the conventional setup of his entire family. He wanted a change. Now, why will somebody want such a change, especially if the author is referring to it? This explicit mention is referring to a certain degree of inference, which goes on to say that if I'm not happy with class A, I will move on to class B. Change of class and practice defines unhappiness. If I'm happy, then why would I want to change class? Clear? Question 72. Question number 73, these are decision making questions. What is the answer to question 73? Both C and D are correct. First you will do C, then you will mark D. Two answers are correct. If you mark C or D, both are correct. 74. Again, C and D both are correct. 74, C and D both are correct. Both A and B are correct. 8 answers, Prajnaparamita. Both will be appropriate, A and B. Whichever one you have marked, both are correct. Santosh, your answer is correct. Manish, your answer is correct. 76. Sonali, your answer is correct. Manish, your answer is correct to 76. Krishna Balanita, your answer is correct to 76. Both B and C are correct. Santosh, your answer is 76. D, E for Delhi is wrong. Sonali, 77 question. Both C and D are correct. Monish, 77C is correct and D is also correct. Santosh, 77C is correct. Kriti Sharma, 77C is correct. Rajni Paramita, 77C is correct. C and D, both of them are correct in this. Whichever one you mark, both you will be scored equally well for both of them. 78. Paramita, 78A is correct. Preeti Sharma, 78D is also correct. Monish, 78D is also correct. A and D both are correct. Santosh, Sonali, Monish, both of you, all three of you are correct. Preeti Sharma, Rakshni Paramita, both of you are correct. 79, A and B both are correct. Preeti Sharma, you are correct. 79, B is correct. Monish, 80, A is correct. Sonali, 80, B is also correct. Rakshni Paramita, 80, C is incorrect. Always remember, in an executive decision making situation, remember to go by that kind of a mindset in which you are calmer, to take into consideration more things, are not getting into a conflict directly, not addressing the issue. You will have to circumvent it for the time gap to be exploited as a mature option. Rakshni Paramita, 80C is incorrect. Santosh, 80A is correct. Rakshni Paramita, Mohanty, 80C will be incorrect. Because you cannot scrap the project. Scrapping of a scenario will not bring you to the right conclusion. You will have to take into consideration in the very first place why that project was built up. Santosh, 80A is correct. The quant and DI questions. The discussion will begin in 2 minutes.
Given here is PL Coaching Institute for CCAT and case of different countries 11 and 12, the number of enrollments are given. It is also known as the enrollment, total number of enrollments for this is 15,000 and 18,000 respectively, right? So if I say this, this total is 15,000. This is 15,000 and this is 18,000. Now one thing we can do is, first we need we calculate all the percentage of Mumbai, Pune, Delhi and so on and forth. Or we can just go by the options, by the questions. Right, sometimes it is necessary to find the all the data which is given, and sometimes it is okay that if you go by the questions only. So you see the first question, which city shows the highest decline in the number of enrollments in 12 or over 11, okay? So, highest decline from this to this. If you see the percentages, this 15 and 18 is, there is no much difference, right? So, 24 become 10. Okay? So, this may be one of the case that higher decline is there. So, if you calculate 24% of 15,000, which comes out to be 3600. Okay? Right, and 10% of this is 1800. Right, okay. So, what is the difference here? It is not talking about percentage decline, right? It's talking about highest decline in the number of enrollments. So, difference here is 1800 now, okay? For Mumbai, the value is 1800, okay? Then Pune is 18 becomes 12, not much difference is there. Delhi increased, so this could not be my answer. Lucknow remains same, could not be my answer. Kolkata, 25 becomes 8, right? 25% of 15,000 is 3750, and 8% of 1800 is 1440. So difference is 2310, which is more than 1800, so my right answer is Kolkata only. Right? So answer is C. Clear? Okay. For other reasons, suppose you need to calculate all the percentages for particular question, not for this, okay? So the easiest way what we can do is Mumbai is simply 15 into 24 you need to do, that is 360, that comes here. Now most of the data we can calculate using the logic of 24% only. We need not to calculate 18% of 1500 separately. Why? Because 18 is nothing but 3 by 4 of 24, right? So you just need to do 3 by 4 of 3600, which gives you 2700. Right? 8 is, if we talk about Delhi, 8 is 1 third of 24. So 1 third of 36 is 12. So this can save your time. 15% of 3600 directly my grade nahi kar paunga, but so I need to find only 15% of 3600 is 2250, right? Of 50,000, sorry. So it becomes 2250. 25% is 3750. 10% is simply 360. Sorry. 1500. Right. So this can be deployed. 26. If the enrollment fee in 11 and 12 was 1000 rupees and 1200 rupees respectively, what was the percentage increase in total revenue by PPL from CKT densities over this and this? No breakup is required. 11, in the first case, total enrollment is 15,000. Enrollment fees is 1,000 and the second case 18,000 and the enrollment is 1,200. Forget the zeros, just 150 into 10 is nothing but 1,500 and 180 into 12 is nothing but 2,160. So that's it. The increase of 660 over 1500 into 100 will give you the answer as 44%. B is the right answer. Clear with this part, all of you? Next. What was the percentage change in the total revenue number of enrollments from Delhi and Lucknow together from 12 over 11? Okay. Delhi and Lucknow together. So Delhi and Lucknow together, here it is 1200 plus 2250, which is nothing but 3450,
right?
And in this case, Delhi plus Lucknow is 40%, right? So 40% of this is 7200. So there is an increase of 3750 over 3450 into 100, right? My two options are close, 109, 10. More than 100, right? So if you see the difference, if the upper part is nothing but 3450, so my answer has to be 100%, okay? But this is how much more than this? 300 more than this. 300 upon 3450 is almost 10%, because 10% of this is 345. So my answer has to be slightly less than 10, or 100 plus 10. So the only option left is 109. We need to try to not to calculate the exact value for this, okay? Am I clear? Answer becomes 109. If the number of reports enrollments in Pune is 11 and the city X is 12 is safe, find the city X. Okay. Pune is 4700. Now which of these two becomes this will become 4700? 10% of this is nothing. Cannot think of this 1800, right? 12% of this is not there. 2 or 6 are 25%, this is 450 around, right? And Lucknow will be 15% of 1800 is how much? 2700. So this is my answer. Okay? Are you clear? Any doubt left? Now move to question number 40. One part. What is the answer? In how many ways four married couples be seated around the center table such that the spouse sit opposite to each other? There is a circular table. 8 chairs. You already know that you can start from any chair in a circle, right? Starting point is not given, okay? So, the first male can sit anywhere, suppose the first male is here. So, this is only one case. One possibility, right? Now, his spouse has to sit here. Does that the spouse sit opposite? The spouse has to be at this place only. There is only one chance again. The second male has six possibilities. He can sit here. So he has six possibilities. And again his spouse will sit next to each other. For example, wo yahan baith jate hain. Right. So the third person ke paas abhi four choices ban jayenge. This and this. And the last one has two choices. So this is my answer. That is 48. First male do not have 8 possibilities because it's a circle, not a straight line. Right? In a circle, I can start from any point. You put here or here, that does not make a difference in a circle. In line, it does make a difference, right? Open Angel. Very good question, huh? Govind sells two different articles at the same price, probably rupees Y, okay? Selling prices Y and Y for two articles. 10% profit on the one and 10% loss on the other. How many different values of y can take that if you know that y is more than 1 and less than 100 and the amount of loss suffered by Govind is an integer. Okay. You must have read that if you sold two articles at same price, one at 10% profit, one at 10% loss, overall loss is always x square by 100, where x is the percentage, right? Which is 10 here. So 10 square by 100 becomes 1%. My loss has to be 1%. Is that clear? This loss is 1%. So can I say that my cost price has to be, sorry, my selling price has to be 0.99 of CP, right? Okay. So if selling price is 0.99 of CP, can I say 0.9 SOP is nothing but 2y, because selling price is 2y only? This gives you CP as 2y upon 99 into 100. Okay, and my selling price was 2y. So my loss is this minus this, right? 200y upon 99 minus 2y is nothing but 2y upon 99, which is nothing but y upon 49.5. This is my loss. And he is saying that loss has to be integer, right? Amount of loss has to be integer. If y upon 49.5 is an integer, so y can either be 49.5 or the next multiple of it, which is 99. There's only two of possibilities, so answer is 2, not 1. Am I clear, Shweta? Any measure wrong with this? Answer is 2, D. We keep saying, please explain again, okay? Selling price is Y and Y, profit percent and loss percent is 10%. Is this part clear to all of you that X square by 100 is a loss by? That is 1% is loss in the complete transaction, right? So if 1% loss is there, my selling price is 0.9 of CP. Or you can assume that CP is X, right? So loss is 1% of X. Is nothing but x upon 99. Right. Sorry. X upon 100. So my selling price will become x minus x upon 99 100 is 99 x by 100, which is given as 2y. So x will come out to be 200. 99, which I have written here, cost price. Clear, Preeti? Then I just take a difference and we find the value of loss as this, y upon 49.5. If it is an integer, there are only two possibilities, 49.5 and 99. So two answers here. All of you clear? For question number 40 again. In a circle, first person can sit anywhere, so he always has only one chance, not eight. Is that correct here? So if first male, suppose yahan baith jata hai, his wife can sit only at this point. Okay, so first person has one possibility. His wife also has one possibility. The second person has three chances now. This, and this. And his wife has to sit opposite to him. So suppose वो यहाँ बैठ गया, तो उसकी wife यहाँ ही बैठेगी. अब मेरे पास चार options बचते हैं. This and this. और उसको बढ़ाने के बाद मेरे पास four two options बचेंगे. That's right. Right? 6 into 4 into 2, 40. Second. The answer is 34. Any doubt in this? This was an easy question. 34. Any doubt in this? 42. Question for 42. Anyone has a doubt? Okay, string. Total of 10 numbers is A. Average of 10 numbers is A. So total, can I say, is nothing but 10 A. 5 numbers are added. The average is A plus 5. That means total is 15 numbers are there now. And the average is A plus 5. But total becomes 15 A plus 75. So the new 5, the total of the new 5 should be this minus this. This minus this becomes 5a plus 75. And the average of new 5 becomes this upon 5 is nothing but a plus 15. And what is asking to you? Product of a and the average of new, that is a plus 15. And the value of a is given as 2, so 2 into 17, that is 34. Clear? If a certain number is double and the result is decreased by 9, the number obtained is a prime number between 15 and 21, which are the following, can be the original number. Right. There is slight mistake in this. Not mistake, I can say. I can say there is a fault in the forming of this question. In any of these type of questions, when we say that which of the following can be the original number, options should not be cannot be determined. But this option, obviously, if you are asking for which of the following can be, that means there are multiple answers. So my obvious answer is cannot be determined. Right. So without solving anything, I can mark this. Because he's already doubting this part. Which of the following can be a original number? That means there are more than one. If there are more than one, my obvious answer has to be cannot be determined. So generally, this type of option is not there in this type of question. Okay. Otherwise, the question is easy. You just need to check the options and get your answers. 12 into 2 minus 9 will give you 15, which is not a prime number. So this is not my answer. 13 into 2, 26 minus 9 will give you 17, which is a prime number. So this could be there. And this gives you 19, which is also a prime number between 15 and 21. So these two are correct. So I have two answers. That means I cannot be true. So my right answer is C. Am I clear? Okay, next one. Ratio based questions. Three athletes, PQR, participate in a 100 meter race. P beats by 20 meter. P beats Q by 20 meter. What it means, when P finishes the race, Q was 20 meter behind. That means when P runs 100 meter, Q runs only 80. Is that clear? Beats by 20 meter means he was 20 meter behind. Okay. Now, and R beats P by 20 meter in a 100 meter race again. So when R runs 100 meter, P runs 80 meter now. Are the two statements clear? What is asking now? R kitne meter se beat karega? Q go in 200 meter race, not 100, right? Now think logically. When R goes 100 meter, P goes 80 meter. This is very much clear from the second part. Now, if you see here, when P goes 100, Q goes 80. Now, P is going 80 only. Think of unitary method only. P jab 100 jata hai, toh Q 80 jata hai. Abhi P jana hai 80. So, Q jana chahiye 80 upon 100 into 80. Unitary method, which is 64. Is it clear? Jab R 100 gaya, toh P 80 gaya. Aur jab P 80 jayega, toh कितना जाना चाहिए 80 upon 80 into this part 64. ये 100 जा रहा है, ये 64 जा रहा है, मतलब 36 मीटर से बीट कर रहा है 100 मीटर की रेस में. ये रेस है 200 मीटर की, तो आंसर हैज टू बी डबल 72. राइट टू दिस 44. ओके, अगेन what? Why are you not considering the distance traveled by PQR? PQR as 180 and 60. Okay? If you are saying this is 100, this is 100, this is 80 and this is 60. The problem is, 80 and 60 means 80 meter ki race mein wo 20 meter se hai. Usne aisa thodi bola hai. He is saying jab ye 100 jata hai to ye 80 jata hai. And jab ye 100 jata hai to ye 80 jata hai. Right? Rahul, is it clear? Now see, ye ratio ka question hai simply. P or Q ka ratio hai 100:80. P और R का रेशो है 80:100. मुझे एक जनरल रेशो निकालना है इनका. तो जब R 100 जाएगा, तो P जाएगा 80. अब यहाँ से लॉजिक निकालते हैं. P और Q में जो लॉजिक क्या है मेरे पास? जब P 100 जाता है, तो Q 80 जाता है. तो जी, जब P 1 जाएगा, तो ये 80 अपॉन 100 चलेगा. और जब ये 80 जाएगा तो ये 80 अपॉन 100 टू 80 चलेगा. विच इज रिटन हियर ओनली, विच इज नथिंग बट 64, यानी Q 64 जा रहा है, नॉट 60. नाउ सी द डिफरेंस, 36 मीटर से बीट करेगा उसको इन 100 मीटर रेस. रेस डबल है, 72 आंसर होना चाहिए, राइट? ओके. Is a good question. The speed of Govind and Sunil around the circular track is 10 and 3 rounds per minute. Generally, the speed should be given in meter per second or kilometer per hour, right? This is rounds per minute, so I have to convert this. The length of the track is not given. So you can assume it as anything which is a multiple of 10 and 3, 30, right? Let's assume 60 meters. Okay, so that fractions should not be made, right? Fraction nahi banne chahiye, otherwise calculation tough ho jati hai. So let's assume it is 60 meters. Now 10 round means 600 meters, right? So 600 meters ja raha hai 1 minute, yani ki 60 second mein. So Govind ki speed ho jayegi 10 meter per second. And Sunil का similarity हो जाएगा 3 meter per second. Because वो 3 round जाएगा, 3 into 60 is 180, 180 upon 60 is 3. Okay. So 60 meter is the length, the speeds are 10 and 3. Okay. Right. The very first question I can ask you is, when the two person will meet for the first time? First meeting, no, LCM नहीं निकालते हैं. श्वेता LCM जब निकालेंगे, जब आपको ये पूछा जाएगी वो first time starting point पे कब मिलेंगे. I am asking for the very first time, पहली इनकी मीटिंग कब होगी. उसके लिए हम करते हो circumference 60 upon relative speed, which in this case is 10 plus 3, 60 upon 13. फर्स्ट मीटिंग 60 अपॉन 13 टाइम में होगी, सेकंड में. इज इट क्लियर? अब वो क्या पूछ रहा है, इन हाउ मेनी टाइम्स विल दे क्रॉस ईच अदर बिफोर सुनील रीचेस द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. सुनील को स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट पे पहुंचने में 60 अपॉन 3 उसकी स्पीड है, तो 20 सेकंड लगेंगे. If teacher is asking what is relative speed, relative speed is if two person are moving in the opposite direction, you have to add the two speeds. If they are moving in the same direction, you have to subtract the two speeds. You have to assume that one of them is stationary, so what should be the speed of the other body, right? In case of same direction, we will subtract this and opposite ke liye plus kare. Clear teacher? Again, their first meeting will be after 60 upon 30 seconds, and Sunil will cover this part in 20 seconds. The number of meetings in this place has to be the division of these two, which is nothing but 20 upon 60 60 by 13. Right, which is nothing but 30 upon 3, that is 4 point something. 4.33. So definitely my number of meetings has to be 4. Is it clear? In 20 seconds, वो 4 पॉइंट मिल चुके होंगे, उसके बाद थोड़ा पॉइंट और भी आगे निकल चुका होगा. Rahul, we have to use the concept of relative speed because we need to know when will they meet for the first time. Otherwise, how can you find that when will they meet after 20 seconds? How many times will they meet for the 20 seconds? अगर आपको पहली बार का ही नहीं पता लगेगा कितने टाइम में मिलते हैं तो कैसे निकालोगे. इन शॉर्टकट व्हाट यू कैन से इज यू सी दिस 10 एंड 10 बिकॉज रिमेन्स सेम राइट. दिस कैन बी अ शॉर्टकट. क्या ये मिनट में दिया हुआ हो राउंड में दिया हुआ हो आप उसको सीधे मीटर सेकंड में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हो राइट. बट उसमें ये चीज प्रॉब्लम पड़ जाती है. ओके 60 तो एज्यूम करके करना ही पड़ेगा आपको. Next, this is quite a straightforward question. The sum of money invested in school, listening with the Niti, this is the oral question in fact. Sum of money invested at 4% simple interest, double kam ho jayega. Double hone ka matlab hai, aapko 100% interest mil raha hai. Ek saal mein 4% milta hai. Time has to be 25 only, that's it. Is not clear. Anish, पहले बोलना चाहिए राइट. दिस पार्ट इज क्लियर. 60 मीटर एज्यूम कर लिया आपने, स्पीड जानी 10 मीटर पर सेकंड 80 मीटर पर सेकंड मनीष राइट. ओके अब मैं बोल रहा हूँ, वो पूछना है मेरे को कि जब सुनील ने 3 राउंड पूरे कर लिए होंगे तो ये दोनों कितनी बार खर्च हो गए होंगे. सुनील 3 राउंड कवर करेगा 20 सेकंड में राइट. अब मुझे पहले तो ये फाइंड करना पड़ेगा कि वो पहली बार कब मिलते हैं, तभी मैं बता पाऊंगा कि वो 20 मिनट कितना मिलेंगे. ठीक है, फर्स्ट मैंने आपको ये बताया था कि आपको फर्स्ट मीटिंग निकालनी है तो आप करोगे सर्कमफ्रेंस अपॉन रिलेटिव स्पीड 60 अपॉन 10 प्लस 3. तो आपका 60 अपॉन 13 आ गया. ये इसकी फर्स्ट मीटिंग है. 20 सेकेंड टोटल टाइम है. फर्स्ट मीटिंग होती है 60 अपॉन 13 मिनट्स में. तो नंबर ऑफ मीटिंग निकालने के लिए आप दिस अपॉन दिस करोगे 20 अपॉन दिस 13 ऊपर जाएगा. ये कैंसिल होकर 3 देगा आपको. 13 अपॉन 3 आ जाता है 4.3. इसका मतलब 4 मीटिंग तो हो ही चुकी है. आंसर हैज टू बी 4. 20 अपॉन क्यों किया? सपोज मेरा टोटल टाइम है 20 सेकेंड. मेरी फर्स्ट मीटिंग होती है 5 सेकेंड में. नंबर ऑफ मीटिंग कैसे निकालोगे? 20 अपॉन 5 करके निकालोगे ना. अगर एक मीटिंग 5 सेकंड में हो रही है, टोटल 20 सेकंड है तो डिवाइड ही करोगे तभी निकला नंबर ऑफ मीटिंग्स. ठीक, ओके. लैंडलाइन 325, मोबाइल 250, 50 यूज बोथ. इफ दिस इज 50, दिस रिमेनिंग पार्ट हैज टू बी 275. And this remaining part has to be 200. What is asking for? How many number of families who use phones, either phone or landline? That means the summation of all three. So 275 plus 50 plus 200 is 525. And only mobiles is 200 only. So my answer is B. Quite straightforward. 47 done. This is a good question. We have a shortcut of this also. We have a long method as well as a shortcut. Okay. The ratio of milk and water is 3:1. What fraction of the mixture should be replaced with water so that the resultant mixture contains only 50% water? Okay. Sonali is asking why to count 52 times. saying 52 times. What I am saying is, when you find union of all three, you just need to add all these things. Or you are going by the formula union, A union B, which is N, A plus NB, that is 325, plus 250 minus the intersection part, which again gives you 525 only. So I'm definitely not counting 52 times. Obviously, if you are doing this, you count 2 times. That's why you need to subtract for this. Right. 3:1 is the ratio of milk and water. Kitna mixture replace karu, kitna fraction, so that resultant mixture contains 50% water. 50% water means 50% water, 50% milk. So ratio has to be 1:1. Final ratio has to be 1:1. Am I clear? शॉर्टकट में बात करें या फिर पहले लॉन्ग कट में बात करें राइट सपोज टोटल मिक्सचर वाज 60 इन द फर्स्ट केस 60 लीटर सो मिल्क वाज 45 एंड वाटर वाज 15 ओके और वो ये पूछ रहा है कि कितना पार्ट रिप्लेस करें सपोज उसने x लीटर रिप्लेस किया Manish, I am coming to that only. That is a shortcut that we are talking about, okay? X liter replace kiya, so X liter mein milk aur water ka ratio yahi rahega 3:1. That means kitna water replace, so kitna milk replace hoga, that you can calculate. Right, remaining ratio you can find out. Right, and that will be equal to this one. See. So, aapne 60 X liter replace kiya hai, X liter nikalenge, to uska 3/4 of X milk hoga 1/4 of x water hoga so my final milk is 45 minus 3/4 x water is 15 minus 1/4 of x aur maine water se replace kar diya hai to plus x yahan pe ho jayega this upon this is equal to 1/1 this is one of the solution right which is quite long okay now shortcut okay obviously exam mein aisa mujhe bilkul nahi karna hai Think of the logic, in the complete process, what is the part which does not change? Because I am replacing a mixture, so complete solution, the total solution will not change, the quantity of total solution will not change. Am I clear? Milk will change, definitely water will change, quantity, but total, because I am replacing it, so my total quantity will not change. Here 3+1, 4 comes, here 1+1, 2 comes. So total, if I have to equal, so can I make this 2:2? So that my original idea should be clear that my total should not change, right? So 3+1 4 ho gaya, 2+2 4 ho gaya. Now keval observe karo, mera basic idea change ho chuka hai. Milk is process mein kyun change ho raha tha? Because you are replacing, when you are replacing, when you are removing. Point is, total solution should not change. Is that clear? Because the part you have replaced is you are removing, you are replacing it again. So 3+1 is 4. Isko bhi mujhe 4 karunga tabhi mera baat ban sakta hai. Right? Because total should be not. So if this is 4, I have to make this 2:2. Right? In replacement, one thing need to be sure that if you are removing something, suppose you are removing 1/4 of the mixture, okay? 1/4 aapne mixture nikala hai. So 1/4 uska milk रिमूव हो जाएगा 1/4 की वाटर रिमूव हो जाएगा द फ्रैक्शन यू आर रिमूविंग ऑल द इंग्रेडिएंट्स विल बी रिमूव्ड इन द सेम फ्रैक्शन इज दिस पार्ट क्लियर इज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर अगर आप 1/10 मिक्सचर निकालते हो तो आपका 1/10 मिल्क बाहर आ जाता है रेशियो इज डिफरेंट थिंग Suppose I have 60 liters of milk plus water solution, which is in the ratio 3:2. Okay? So, my milk is nothing but 36 liters and my water is nothing but 24 liters. Now, if I say 20 liter mixture is removed, so ratio of milk and water in this 20 liter is nothing but 3:2 only. That does not create any difference. So, milk in this part is 12 and water is nothing but 8. The ratio has to be remain same. Is it clear? Till now, am I clear? Preeti, am I clear? In 20 liters, the ratio has to be same, right? Now, see this. You are removing 20 out of 60, which is 1/3. And if you see the milk part, 12 is removed out of 36, which is again 1/3. 8 out of 24 is also 1/3. That's what I'm talking about. When you are removing 1/3 of the mixture, milk will remove as 1/3 and water will remove as 1/3. अपनी क्वालिटी का 1/3 रिमूव हो जाएगा, जितना मिल्क था उसका 1/3 मिल्क बाहर आ जाएगा, जितना वाटर था उसका 1/3 बाहर आ जाएगा। अभी क्लियर है क्या? So you can remove 1/10 of the mixture, 1/10 will be in the ingredients will become out. Am I clear? Manish, Mohanty, Preeti. Okay. Now apply this logic here. Okay. The reversibility of this logic is what? Now I am saying is, if you remove 1/3 of the mixture, all the ingredients will come out in the same ratio, 1/3. From the question, if you say, if you able to calculate that 1/3 of the mixture is removed, 1/3 of the milk is removed. Suppose question se aapko pata lag jata hai ki 1/3 milk nikal gaya hai. Can I say that 1/3 of the mixture should be removed? Once removed, reverse logic. If any ingredient is removed as 1/3, the mixture should be removed as 1/3 also. By reversibility of the logic, right? So see here now it is. What we have done is, I make this as 4 and 4, so that this ratio becomes same. If you think on the milk part only, milk is changing only because of replacement. Water is changing because of replacement as well as addition. So I will not think on this. Okay, I just need to make sure, make the point of water, sorry, milk. Milk was changed only because of removal. What is the quantity of milk in the earlier case? 3. Now it is 2. So how much milk is removed? 1 out of 3. My answer has to be 1/3. Because when you are removing milk, 3 becomes 2. That means 1 is removed out of 3. Agar milk 1/3 nikla hai, to mixture bhi 1/3 nikla hoga. Going with the reversibility of logic. Is it clear? Please write. Is it clear? Yes or no? So this is a shortcut here. You need to make the total of the T's to same and just observe that part which is changing only because of removal, and the fraction can be easily calculated out of this. 3 becomes 2, removal of 1 out of 3, 1/3 is done. This is a shortcut, right? Any doubt? This is a straightforward question, I can say. So, which discussion ke liye nahi bachta hai. Okay, what is left? Question number 54. Is there anything again, I think? Manish, which question you are talking about? 49, okay. 49, you are saying options check करके कर सकते हैं क्या? कर सकते हैं, बट वो थोड़ा सा लेंथी हो जाएगा, इसमें कुछ करने के लिए कुछ नहीं बचा है. You just observe the chain rule. If x is his income, he spent 1/6 of this, that means remaining is 5/6. Then he 1/5 is removed, so 4/5 बच जाएगा. Then 1/3/4 is removed, so 1/4 बच जाएगा. And this has to be 1500. ये कर दिया, ये कर दिया, मतलब 15 × 6 का मैं सिर्फ ऑप्शन लेकर जाऊँ. Sweta, which question you are talking about? SCF method? 54, okay. Coming to that. There is no enough SCF. It's simply dimensions is given of the brick as well as for the wall. You just need to divide. Just convert this meter into centimeter and divide it. 0.1 meter is nothing but 10 centimeters, 30 centimeters, 1000 centimeters. Divide by 5 into 4 into 2 will give you the answer. Okay. 55. Okay, this is again a good question. A group of 6 people comprising of 3 boys A, B, C and 3 girls B, Q are sitting. Are to sit around a circular table and just set such that no two girls sit next to each other. If no two girls sit next to each other in a circle, this clearly means that boys and girls has to sit on alternate position, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Is that clear? Why in a line, it is not necessary. Okay, because he is asking for no two girls that should sit together, not about for boys. So there may be a chance that girl, boy, boy, girl, boy, girl. This may be a case in the linear arrangement, but it is not possible in circular because in that case these two girls again are adjacent. So in a circular way, saying that no two girls are sit together, so boys will differently dividing it. Has to be alternate position also. Find the probability that A sits opposite to B. अभी हमने बात की थी कि first position तो contention नहीं होता है. Suppose A यहाँ बैठा है. और इसके opposite में girl बैठेगी. And that girl can be anything, anyone from P, Q and R. Anyone out of P, Q, R means 1/3 is the probability 0.33. The question looks difficult, but it is easy. Right? Any doubt in this? Again, okay. What I am saying is, in a circular table, if it is mentioned that no two girls sit together, the boys will be differently bitana padega. There is no chance of like this, in the, which is the linear arrangement is there, right? So if boys and girls are on alternate positions, so, suppose A yahan baitha hai, to uske samne girl hi baithegi. Which can be P, Q or R. Teen possibilities mein mujhe koi ek chahiye, so my probability straight away 1/3. Right? Is it clear? Out of 3, 1 is the possibility, 1/3 is the probability. How many zeros in factorial 46? How will you calculate the number of zeros in factorial? Just give you a shortcut, right? Don't think about the fundamental about this. Okay, fundamental is quite large actually, quite long. If you need to find the number of zeros in 6 factorial, you need to just divide it by 5. Until then, when the division is not possible. 46 upon 5 will give you what? 9. Again, divide this by 5 will give you what? 1. Add it, that is your number of zeros. Straightforward. Okay, suppose is asking for 100 factorial. Number of zeros in 100 factorial. 100 upon 5 is 20. Upon 5, 4. Answer is 24. Is it clear? Similarly, 46 upon 5 is 9. Upon 5, 1. Add it. 10 is your answer. Clear with this? Number of zeros, then divide by 5. If today is Monday, what day will be after 65 days? After 65 days का मतलब हुआ 66th day की बात कर रहे हैं। यहाँ पे ये मंडे को बोलती है। And you must have heard about the concept of quantities in the month class of calendar GMA2 I guess. Okay. So if you convert 66 into weeks, divided by 7. 9 weeks will be there and 3 days are remaining. This is called odd days. Okay. So, if today is Monday, on 66th day, 9 weeks to complete ho jayenge, so my day will repeat after this. उसके बाद मुझे काम फिनिश करना है 3 more days. So, Monday plus 3. Thursday. If you had solved it by 65, the answer was Wednesday, which is the wrong answer. Right. This is quite obvious wrong answer. Move on. Successor discount of 10%, 20%, 25% will be equal to single discount of all. There are various methods of this. Discount of 10% means 9 by 10, 20% means 4 by 5, 12 by 5, 12 by 5 is 1 by 8, so 7 by 8. You can straight away solve this. Or you can assume the initial price was 100. After 10% discount, it becomes 90. After 20% discount, 20% of this is 18, becomes 72. After 12.5%, which is 1 by 8, 1 by 8 of this is 9, becomes 63. 100 becomes 63. Means 37% discount. In these type of question, it is always easy to assume 100. Question will be set properly. So, 58 done, right? Do we have any doubt in this part? The AR part, 4 questions, should I discuss it? Anyone has a doubt? Not needed. Okay. 56 may be doubt bacha hua hai abhi. Acha. Preeti 56. I am giving you a shortcut, Preeti. Question. In any 100 factorial, let's say in 500 factorial, number of zeros find करने हैं आप. Actually, this should be trailing zeros. Means last में कितने zeros आएंगे? For example, 1000 में last में 3 zeros आते हैं. तो 3 number of trailing zeros आते हैं. So number of trailing zeros आपको find करना है. So just divided by 5. So 500 upon 5 is 100. Upon 5 is 20. Upon 5 is 4. So answer is 124. No, 124. Sweta. 20 को फिर से डिवाइड करना पड़ेगा आपको जब तक वो कंप्लीटली डिवाइड नहीं होता है 4 के बाद डिवाइड नहीं कर पाऊंगा तो मार्क रखना पड़ेगा आपको तो 124 इज द आंसर इन 500 तक इज इट क्लियर प्रीति नाउ ओके यार इज डन द 63rd इज दैट द फर्स्ट एंड लास्ट का asking in the question of 58, can you use a plus b plus a by 100? 58. Yes, you can, but you have to apply this process twice. So that becomes a lengthy process. In case of 3 or 4 or 5 discoms, should not be done, right? You can, but you are wasting your time. If you are saying you did not get the answer by this, then the problem is, maybe this is a discount, so you have to take this negative. You must have taken this as positive. Priti, have you taken this as a negative or positive numbers? We have to put minus 10 and minus 20, not 10 and 20. 10 and 20 will give you the wrong answer. You have discount, decreasing. Right? Use minus 10, minus 20 and minus 12.5 gives you the answer, right? Shall we move on? Shweta, can you calculate the number of zeros in 600 factorial? It is 600 factorial, not 600, right? 600 will multiply two zeros only. 600 upon 5 is 20, upon 5 is 24, upon 5 is 4, so the answer is 148. Right, Shweta? Can I move on? After 58 and here, what we have done in the previous question now. First term is 1, nth term is, last term is 50. Each term is an integer. How many such distinct AP exist? So my TN is 50. A is 1, right? My nth term is always defined as A plus N minus 1 into D. Okay, so I put it here, 50 is equal to 1 plus N minus 1 into D. So N minus 1 into D is nothing but 49. So this is a number, this is a product of two numbers. So I have to factorize it. There are three possibilities, 1 cross 49, 7 cross 7, or 49 cross 1. Okay, so I have three possibilities. That means there are three AP which exists. 63, clear or not? Some students have a doubt that if n is minus 1 is equal to 1 in this case, so n becomes 2. Can the number of students in an AP can be 2 or not? Can I say 2 and 4 are in AP? The angel says yes, we can. The basic fundamental was that the common difference should be same, that is on an AP, right? The problem is, how can you say the common difference is same when you do not know the third term? Actually, this is a confusing topic. This is a quite debatable topic. Right? There is no finite answer till now here. Some people say there can be, some people say there cannot be, by the definition. Right? But in any way, there must be two options to have. As I best go out, the answer is 2, which is not in the options. So my best possible answer is 3. Right. Now, the problem exists when 2 is one of the answers. In that case, it's better to leave that question. Because there is still debate going on this topic. So, we are not sure about this, but AP can exist with 2 terms or not. Both persons have different logic behind the theory of that, right? So, I can't negate anything. दोनों के फंडामेंटल अलग हैं. कुछ कहते हैं कि यहाँ पर AP की जो प्रॉपर्टी है वो डिफॉल्ट तो नहीं होती है, राइट? दैट मींस जो प्रॉपर्टी है कि डिफरेंस है वो आता तो है ही, चाहे वो सेम आए कैसे भी है, राइट? बट कुछ लोगों का लॉजिक है कि थर्ड टर्म के बिना हाउ कैन यू से कि ये डिफरेंस कांस्टेंट आएगा नहीं आएगा, सो एग्जिस्ट नहीं करेगी. सो जनरली या तो आंसर देगा तो वो एक ही ऑप्शन देगा, तो डाउट का चांस नहीं बचेगा. अदरवाइज इन केस 1% चांस में अगर वो होता है कि दोनों ऑप्शन देगा तो छोड़ देंगे. I guess nothing is left now. Shweta, sorry, 600 factorial when 24 is further divided by 5, then 0 does not come. 0 is what find karne hai aapko, aapko divide karke quotient find karna hai. 600 upon 5 pe aapko 0 count nahi kar rahe the, aap 120 quotient aa raha tha aapka. Again you divide 120 by 5, so 24 is the quotient. Again you divide by 5, the quotient is 4. You need to calculate quotient only. Okay. Sir, Munish is saying that the 3AB can be with D equal to 1, 5 and 10. D mein problem nahi hai. 1, 5 and 10. Why 1, 5 and 10? 5 or 10 kaise aayega yahan par? There are only 3 possibilities. या तो आपका n माइनस वन एंड d इफ यू टॉकिंग अबाउट, ये 1 हो जाए ये 49 हो जाए, ये 7 ये 7 ये 49 और 1, ये 3 पॉसिबिलिटीज है. 5 और 10 का तो चांस ही नहीं है. मनीष d इज इधर 1 और 7 और 49, नॉट 5 और 10. सर व्हाट will be the series 1, 5 and 10. तो कोई भी सीरीज नहीं है ना, AP है GP है. Here common difference is 4, here common difference is 5. तो इसे neither AP nor GP, nor HP or nor any other series. Manish, is it clear? The first series can be 1, 2, 3, 4. What first series do you are talking about? क्या series हुई है? It's an AP. Okay, Manish. Is it possible to repeat question number 18? What is 18? Shantanu is left, so at this time we cannot do it. What I can do is, I just gave you the email IDs of Shantanu and me, right? And you just drop your queries on the email, okay? For Shantanu it is shantanu@karlaucher.com. And mine is tarun.malik@karlaucher.com. So if you have any doubt, just mail it, okay? Whether in this mock or the previous mocks. Okay, so no doubt left. Thank you very much. Hope to see you in mock 5 again. Tomorrow we have live analysis at Mukherjee and Rajendranagar, and the day after tomorrow on Wednesday we'll have a GK webinar at the same time. Okay, so be there. Thank you. Preeti, you can get the mocks for the previous recording or the previous mocks. For mock 3 you can get, because that was done online, okay? But for mock 1 and mock 2, Nordics is not possible at this time of time. For the further mocks, next two mock होंगे, उसके लिए recording आपके SIS पे available होंगे. Okay, Pradeep.